on this episode of Crappie Kings TV. Hey, back in Louisiana, Lake Darbonne, this time with another duck commander, John Godwin.
And he comes around the boat and introduces himself, and I notice right off, he talks funny. Hey.
Look what daddy's got.
I got hung up in one of them's face.
He pulls up in his big boat, big truck. It's a Cadillac Crappie boat. And was it rigged to the T's? Big time. Another one.
Hey, can you do this?
Yes.
Here.
Ow! Did you fight that crappie?
Well, we knew they were there. We knew we could catch them this way, but there's a storm on the horizon.
I think you got one there.
He's on.
Daddy's got one again.
Oh, it's on that chartreuse line.
You give your woman that stuff, she gives you gas money, bait money. Go get me some more of that.
This is a blast. Really, small jig heads, little grubs, behind the boat, ultralight little duck commander poles.
Looks like a grumpy old man. You take your medicine this morning?
I'm Carl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. Hey, back in Louisiana, Lake Darbonne, this time with another duck commander, John Godwin, and my buddy, Stone Cold Crappie Killer, Jay Stone. What we're gonna do today is a little bit different. Wind's gonna come up, storm's coming up, so long lining on some areas that only two people in the world know. But with all you people watching, if you saw the other show with me and Jay, you saw it, but there's no way in the world we're giving you waypoints. I have to sign a disclaimer, because if I give it to you, you'll never find me again in Louisiana. So let's get out there before the wind gets up, have some fun, catch some crappie. Let's go.
So Jay tells me, Jack's called him, and we're gonna do this show called Crappie King, which is exciting, because when we ain't chasing them ducks, we're chasing them crappie pretty good.
All right, Jay, let's have some fun. Where do you want me to sit? All right. Am I excited about meeting John Godwin? You bet. I watch the series that he's on, his family, friends, real good people. And this guy, as true as it comes. He pulls up in his big boat, big truck. It's a Cadillac Crappie boat. And was it rigged to the T's? Big time.
Here we go.
So we get down to the boat ramp, and he comes around the boat and introduces himself, and I notice right off, he talks funny. Hey.
Are any of your baits dragging down?
It don't look like it.
They're bumping. It's my
two bumping.
Yeah, two center ones are okay. Now, if you bring it closer.
If you got one bumpy, you need to reel it in and tie on something lighter.
All right.
So we get on the spot. We get our lines. We get our baits picked out. What we're going to do, we're going to use try 1/16. May have to go down to 1/24 to get the right depth on the speed we're gonna be going, but it's a pretty easy technique. All you'd really do is you have a bait and you got these ultralights, throw them out as far as you can throw them, set them in the rod holder, sit back and watch.
You got them, John, eh? Yep. That's what I get for looking away. Where's that net? See that?
Boy,
thank you, sir.
He eat that sucker. He said, we're gonna look here.
I just put that one on with the chartreuse with the pink.
Well, oh man.
Nice one, John.
124.
124.
Whoa.
Another one.
Hey, can you do this?
Yes.
Here. Ow.
You need to fight that crappie?
Hook in the finger.
Oh, yeah. He's not as big as John's there, but we just traded poles there.
Yeah, I caught your fish, he caught mine.
Look at that. Yours can eat mine.
I tell you what I'm gonna do.
That one can go back? Eat. That one's good enough? Or that's too small to eat?
Is that too?
Yeah, too small.
Okay. See, we do practice live release.
God, that hurt.
What was that?
You throw that back? No, stop. I got a long.
You want me to throw that? The little one? I asked Jay, he says too small.
Boy, if Granny seen you do that.
You know, casting small little jigs behind the boat, different lengths, different depth, different line, and it's important. You think, okay, they're just casting anywhere, but it's about the speed you're going, the line diameter, and the size of the jig head. That's how you're gonna catch crappie. Yeah, I think so there.
He's still in there.
Yep,
we got there. One. You got another?
Yeah, I think it's on that other one there. Where is he, on this side? Yep. Oh, he wants to tangle
there
up.
There you go. Oh, yeah.
He's not too bad, isn't he? Can I just lift him in? He's not a real big one, is he?
Nah.
Come here, you, crappie. But he's an eater.
How are you? Look, I got somewhere for him right there. He got a buddy in there.
Thank you, sir. Well, then we figured out that size pretty fast, Jay. 124 seemed to be the ticket, man. The appeal of crappie. There's so many ways to catch them.
Yeah.
Any way from shore, big boats, small boats, it doesn't matter.
Everybody's got their own way they do it.
Yeah.
And you always say, how'd they catch them like that?
Yes.
Well, that's a pretty good fish.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yes. That is a pretty big fish.
I don't know if that's a. Yeah, it is a white perch. It's a bull.
Oh boy. Look at that rod go. John's got a hog there. Look what daddy's got.
I got hung up in one of them's face.
Look how they pull, eh? Isn't that fun?
It is.
Man, oh man.
Especially on these ultralight. Look at that.
My, oh my.
Right on the top
Holy
of the head.
Holy cow,
too.
John, that is a horse, buddy. Look at that thing. Come here, horse. Do not. Oh my goodness. That is a horse.
He found it.
Hey? Look at that thing. Wow. That's what we'll be looking for, John. Wow. Nice one, Jay.
That's a female.
Hey?
Look at wow. Look at the shoulders on
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah.
I was about to wonder.
Oh man, that's stud. Good stuff. Man, when you set like that and they just stay down, at first you're almost like, huh? Wow, stud. Oh yeah.
We got him then.
There's some nice fillets there.
Ain't nothing like it. Man.
The line just got tight, eh?
That thing was pulling drag.
Yep.
You let the guy that's running the trolling motor think he knows everything. That way, you can just sit back in the back of the boat. You got a guy right here beside you that's come from way off going fishing with you, so you can communicate with him. You know, you just don't pay him no mind up there. But he thinks he's really doing something, you know, going through the right contours and getting you to the right spots. But which he does, but you know, you don't let him know that. You just sit back and watch your rods.
Oh boy.
Well,
oh yeah. Oh, he's there.
He's there.
Oh, that's a big fish again. Oh my Lord. Oh, the net's way up there. I'm gonna run and gun. You got one too? No. Oh.
Would you net this fish for
me? Yes, sir.
He's
got some lines and stuff. That's all right. Another rod bender.
Oh, rod
just an eater.
Hey. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a Lake Crisco crappie.
He'll be here all week,
he said. Let me fix my bait. A little old bait still doing. Is your bait still doing
that,
good?
That was the color you had? Was it chartreuse again?
Oh, are you spitting on your bait?
I should.
That's why you ain't catching none. You got to spit on your bait. My daddy taught me that.
Really?
Yeah. That's what it does.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna pull your spit. Technique here, moving rods and keep throwing to the outside. Boy, I'm glad you come down here.
My pleasure. He's kicking my butt. I'm like net boy. Carl, get the net. Carl, get the net. How's this one? Look at this one. Wow. Is it really again?
Oh dear.
Oh boy. Waiting for that rod to bow over again.
Ooh. Yeah, get it loaded.
Now, when you first hit, when they've got some size, you almost think it's a snag. Mm. Ooh, and then.
Then you feel that
head
shake.
Oh, God. Ah. Yeah, man.
We're going to try a different technique today. We're going to do long lining, which is a great technique for kids also. You can take your kids because it's real easy. They can throw, they always want to throw something. So you can let them throw one time, sit down. They sitting beside you, you can watch them. Really give them some instruction on what's going on and just sit back and wait for them rods to load up. It's a really easy way and fun way to fish.
Your rod right there, there's a fish, yep. Yep.
That's dumb.
Nope, there he is, look at him.
I can't, I'm busy.
Oh boy.
Oh, that's a bull.
Yep.
Kind of busy right here, Jay Stone.
Yep, oh yes.
You want to sit over here a little while?
You got the hot seat. He's got the hot seat, hot bait. This is your day.
We're getting full in there.
You can tell whose show it is,
I'm going to have to use the other side here in a minute.
Yeah. He gets one more, then he's going to come on this side. Hit our limit. Enjoy my day. I'm still going to eat some tonight, so.
You know what the secret is, don't you?
Yeah. That's the deal. This is a blast, really. Small jig heads, little grubs behind the boat, ultralight little duck commander poles, small reels, light line, and catching slabs. Am I in crappy heaven? You bet I am.
Catching.
That's crappy.
That's a crappy.
Oh, my line is around one of these things here.
Let me get the net.
You know what? Oh, look at that, eh? It's around that second eye. Remember that issue I had?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I hope it doesn't cost me to lose this crappie. Oh, yeah, it's going to pull the drag. I'm going to have to retie that when I get him in, hopefully.
Oh, I hear it.
Come on, crappie. Yeah, you can hear that straining?
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on.
This way.
Come here, crappie. That's what Si says when he gets one on.
Thank you, sir.
Look at
wow.
That.
Who said the net was bad? That's a good net.
Wow.
That's a lucky net.
That's a lucky net, Jay. Uh-oh. I'm about to throw you out of the boat.
I'm going to retie that. I got it through in one spot here. Look at that. Oh, boy. And we still got him in. Thank you, John. Another
you
crappie.
Ready to go home?
Oh, not yet. You?
I'm just joshing.
The fish gods are good to us today.
I'm just joking with you.
Louisiana crappie have been really good to us. A lot of fun here, man.
So we got everything set up. Everybody's right. We got the lines out. All the baits are running good. And I don't know what I'm doing. I'm talking, me and Carl talking about something, you know, something. He's catching some walleye or something, I don't know. But all of a sudden, my rod, I look and it's gone.
Wow. He gone.
Is that a rod?
That was a rod.
There's the other one. Watch that one.
Oh.
Yeah, it gone.
So this rod over here, it loads up. I pull, it was a stump. It pulls off. So I'm going to reel in and check my hook, you know, to see if it's bent.
Hey, I caught it.
You got it. Really?
I'm ready and I feel tension.
You got something there.
I think I got my line. I got my line of the other one. I'm reeling. I'm thinking, I really got it.
I got the line of my rod. Oh, but it's going to break. Now it's going to
break. Now what would happen if there's a fish on the other one there?
I got my rod.
I pull up and I see the tip come up, and Carl reaches down there and grabs the rod.
Come here, you.
Get my rod, man. Man.
That's that.
I was going to wash it off when I got home. I didn't know.
Yes.
Might as well do it now, I guess.
That's one part. Now, what if there's a fish on this? Or is it a stump?
I don't know.
I end up grabbing the rod, lean back, and get one of the biggest black crappie of the day. Now, which one is this one on? This is, you know what? You got something on this line, but it's your rod.
Something?
Oh yeah, look, look.
What is that?
Fish.
Well, get him.
All right, I got one. It's not, it's John's pole, but it's a big, big crappie. Jay, this was made for TV, right? Look at the size of that crap.
Whoa!
A black crappie, and he's jumping. Oh my goodness, you could not plan this. Big black slab. Get the rod back.
I'll get the net.
He tried to jump.
Come on. Man, look how beautiful that fish is. I
That's
got you fish.
What pulled your rod out of the holder right there. Pull the rod out of the holder.
That's what pulled the rod out of the holder.
It picks it up and he goes, there's fish on there. And he got my fish. The fish is on there. We got it back. And man, what's the odds of that?
Woo!
you don't have them rods in there. Right?
Hey. I got the fish in the boat and my rod back. You just guide the boat up there and get us on fish.
That is incredible. Really. I just picked up the rod just to feel like maybe there is something there. Yep. So, yeah, I reeled it in, but a fishy is still his fish.
Check that out.
Look at that, eh?
That
yeah,
is beautiful.
Beautiful black. That's my fish because I reeled it in. How many crappie you think in a week you could eat?
How many crappie could I eat in a week? Is that a challenge? I don't know. I tell you what, my wife and my daughter, they eat a good many of them too. I have to eat them while I'm cooking them because if they get you inside,
yes.
It's every man for yourself.
Yes.
We was really wondering if we was going to do well with this because well, we knew they were there. We knew we could catch them this way, but there's a storm on the horizon. And we had to do it. We didn't have but about 2 hours to get this done.
Oh my goodness. Are you a crazy crappie? Wow. I got you.
He come back, didn't he?
Yeah. Oh, I think he's under your boat. Oh, he is. Look at, he's. Uh-oh. He's gonna come up, there's your close shot. Look at that. You can't buy footage like that. Probably could, but it'd be a lot of money. Man, he knocked it and then knocked it again.
Bring that crappie up here.
Alrighty.
There you go.
Thank you, John. You see that? You don't see him net very much. Right in the side of the mouth. He's an eating size crappie. You got a nice close-up of that, girls and boys. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow, they taste good, even in the raw. I wonder if anybody ever ate them like sushi.
I don't know.
Hey, I've never tried it. I like when they're cooked. Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate you catching that
fish. Oh, buddy, yeah. Now, you might just think these guys are really good duck hunters, you know, duck commander, but seriously, they are like crappie commandos. You know how to find them, know what to use, know how to catch them, but my God, do they know how to clean them and cook them? Look at this one.
Well,
right
let
there.
Me catch this fish.
That one looks like a fish.
That's a good.
Want me to get the net?
Got me a big old good. Yeah, you might need a net on this.
Oh, he's coming up way back there. Oh, look at him running. Oh boy. He's jumping, he's doing everything. Oh, that's
Boy,
a nice fish.
Look at that mouth on
yep.
that thing. Perfect.
Beautiful fish.
Come on in here. Crappie.
Come here, crappie. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Oh, come here, you. Look at him surfing in. Mm-hmm. Oh, nice fish. What do you think of that, Jay?
Hey, Jay, I got one.
He got more than one. Look at that thing. Wow.
My live well runneth over. That's the way we like it, huh?
Yeah. Goblin and I catching all these crappie and stuff, but we're just like co-pilots. We got the main guy up at the front. Stone Cold Jay Stone. He knows how to find those fish, how to stay on them. He's on the right contour. And a lot of times he would say, get ready, boys. And those rods would bend.
So we caught a lot of fish. The stinking storm come up, run us off the lake. I didn't want to leave, but I just kept thinking, there's only one thing that I like better than ham sandwiches. That's crappie sandwiches.
And a very big thanks to the Union Parish Tourist Commission and Union Parish Chamber of Commerce. Accommodations for Crappie King staff provided by the Lake Darbonne State Park. Okay. Oh my God. I almost fell out of the boat. You see that? I hooked it like a tarpon. Holy moly. I was expecting a fish to be there. See me lean back. That would have been fun.
That was pretty awesome. That was fun to watch.
Crappie Kings Television, presented by B&M Poles. Wherever fishing takes you, B&M has been there. Young Steels, Ford Lincoln. Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor. Visit us at crappiekings.com.